Hi everyone! Welcome back to Study Hub sa ating mga kaskwela at kalingkod. Kayo po ang Learning Warriors in the New Normal. For today's video, I'm going to share with you some effective tips on how to deal with rude or difficult parents. Although alam naman natin na wala naman talagang rude na parent, wala naman talagang rude na tao, yung sitwasyon, yung concern, yung problema na meron sila, yun yung nagiging cause bakit nagiging rude yung tao. Okay? And specifically, the parent. But before we proceed, please join me in a prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you for this new day. Lead us always, inspire us, and protect us. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so moving forward, tip number one is stay calm and listen actively. So as a teacher, very important po yung ma-maintain mo yung pagiging cool. Diba? And at the same time, makinig ka without interrupting them. So habang kausap mo sila, siguro pwede kang mag-nod. At least that means na nakikinig ka and naiintindihan mo sila. Kasi minsan, gusto lang naman natin na may makinig. Diba? As bilang isang tao, pag may problema ka o may concern ka, gusto mong pakinggan ka muna ano yung concern mo. At least, with that way, by being calm and listening to them, madi-diffuse yung situation. Okay? So that is tip number one. Okay, so tip number two, empathize, say something positive about their child. And alam naman natin, to empathize is about understanding the parent from their perspective. Okay, it's about, even if you don't agree with their behavior, you acknowledge their feelings. It's about putting yourself on their shoes. Alright, and napaka-importante na maramdaman nila yun. And say something positive about their child. Kasi naman, as a parent, they only want to ensure na naaalagaan yung bata sa loob ng school, sa loob ng classroom, safe sa'yo bilang class advisor, safe sa school, hindi nabubuli. Okay? So, at napaka-importante po na nauunawaan natin yung mga magulang na ganyan from their point of view, from their perspective. So, say for example, na involve si student A sa away, you can always say something good about the child, na magaling naman sa loob ng klase si student A, mabait naman siya, it's just that minsan napipikon siya sa simpleng biro, kaya napapaaway. Okay? So, in any situation, there's always something good about the child. So, pwede mong sabihin yun, at least ma-lessen yung negativity na nararamdaman ng nanay o kaya ng tatay. Okay? Okay, so tip number three, identify the main problem. So, as a teacher, napaka-importante po that you're able to identify the issue at hand. Kasi naman baka ang dami ng sinabi ng parent, hindi mo pa rin alam yung main concern. And from this tip number three, it will help you to shift on focusing on solutions, and of course, you need to maintain eye contact. Ibig sabihin, tip number four, it's now about shifting the focus to solutions. And ikaw as a teacher and yung parent need to work together for solutions. Alright? Kasi naman baka you are being caught up also in negativities, you are dwelling more on negativity, dapat, ibigay muna, ano ba yung pwede mong gawin? Ano ba yung pwede mong maitulong doon sa problema? Ganito po ma'am, ganito po nanay, ganito po tatay. Okay? And if the issue need to be escalated to the school principal or kailangan ng tulong ng immediate superior mo, ng department head, it's okay. At least mabibigyan ng mas maayos na solusyon yung problema. Okay? Kasi for sure, mas matutulungan ka din na mag-decide kung ano ba talaga yung dapat na gagawin. Alright? And maintaining eye contact because it will only show that you are paying attention even to the smallest details of the concern. Ibig sabihin, naunawaan mo sila, naunawaan mo yung problema, and you are being sincere kung ano yung magagawa mo as a teacher. Okay? And we move forward to tip number 5, record or document everything. So, napaka-importante po na mag-maintain ka ng logbook, kaya naman ng parent-teacher communication inventory. Of course, my date yun, my time, and then yung nature of the concern or remarks mo, and then ano yung naging agreement. And of course, it should be signed by the parent and by you as a teacher or the class advisor, and ano yung naging agreement nyo. So, everything. So, it should be recorded, okay? Keep a good record of what is happening to your students and ano yung nagiging solution mo when having a conference with the parents as well. Okay? And of course, tip number 6, thank them. Okay, for giving their time, at least you are able to speak with them face to face despite their busy schedules. So talagang naramdaman mo na nandyan sila sa parent para suportahan yung mga anak nila. Okay, and be honest all the time. Kung sa tingin mo yung problema hindi masosolve on your level, so be honest by telling them. And if you feel that you commit mistakes also, there's no problem of admitting your mistakes. Just be honest, okay? Say, for example, also, naging problema yung grades. And then, medyo may concern yung nanay or yung tatay. Sometimes, we need to adhere to your ethics, to your standards, na hindi mo naman kailangang iparamdam na kaya ka lang palang i-manipulate nila, na pwede agad ma-influensyan yung decision mo when it comes to the grades. Okay, but still, you need to explain to them, ano ba bakit ito yung naging grade? Say, for example lang yung concern, bakit ito yung grade ng bata ngayong quarter, and ano yung magagawa, ano yung hindi na isubmit, despite giving them considerations, despite repeated reminders. So for sure, mauunawaan nyo ng nanay or mauunawaan nyo ng parent. Alright? So, yun po yung anim na tips based from real life teaching experience na for sure makakatulong para at least ma-diffuse yung situation, para at least yung mga rude parents mag-slow down sila. And para matulungan mo talaga yung mga parents, ano yung appropriate solutions for their concerns, okay? So thank you so much for listening. I hope you learned something today and hope to see you in the next video. And muting pakiusap lamang sa mga hindi pa po nakakapag-like or subscribe, you can click like and subscribe button and choose also that you will be notified for the upcoming videos. Thank you very much, dear teachers, and bye for now!